This story is a Native American tale that has been handed down through generations. It is called Red Hawk and the Celestial Sisters. Once, in a land, there was a brave warrior named Red Hawk. And Red Hawk had been taught by his grandfather to fish and by his father to hunt. And so as a young man, he was upright and tall and brave and treated all of the animals of the forest with kindness. Each morning he would rise from his lodge and he would go out into the forest. And when he was not hunting for food, he would greet all of the creatures of the earth with warmth. From the little tiny blades of grass and the small ants that would crawl in the dirt, to the high tall trees, the owls, the birds, the bats, all of the things that Red Hawk loved in his land. Now, Red Hawk was also a very fine hunter, and so he would hunt and always give thanks to the Great Spirit for the bounty that would come to him. One day, he was on such a hunt, walking through the woods, looking around with his bow and arrows slung on his back, when he heard strange music. The music seemed to be coming from far off in the meadow, and Red Hawk looked between the trees and then went off toward that music. Well, when he got to the edge of the forest, the music louder than ever, he saw in the middle of the forest nothing. He saw in the middle of the meadow nothing. Red Hawk ran out into the meadow, and only then did he see, not hear any music anymore, but what he saw was a flattened patch of grass, round, even on every side, but flat. Red Hawk looked. There was no path coming from any direction. How did this happen? Thought Red Hawk. How did this grass get flattened just like this? I cannot see a path where someone would have walked or where an animal would have traipsed to make this round circle so flat in the grass here in this very spot. I must wait and think, thought Red Hawk. And so he went back to his lodge, he got his blanket, and went back to the edge of the forest, and behind that tree, he waited. He waited to hear that strange music, for he was sure that that music was connected to how that circle of flattened grass got on the earth. Red Hawk slept there all night beneath the moon. He was not afraid, for the night animals were friends of his, and he could hear the crickets and the early morning frogs and the owl when it swooped overhead, all comforting him, singing him to sleep as if in a lullaby. Well, when the morning sun rose, Red Hawk awoke to the music. He heard it, strange and sweet, climbed out from beneath his blanket and looked. And sure enough, floating from the sky was a basket, round. The roundness of it would fit in that exact spot, Red Hawk knew. And that basket came down from the sky and landed right in that spot. And as the music played, Red Hawk saw 12 girls climb out of that basket. Holding hands, they danced in a circle to the music, and then climbed back into the basket. Red Hawk looked at each, for one seemed to be a little bit older than the next. And the youngest, he thought, was the loveliest of all. And instantly, his heart was captured by her. And he thought, I must do whatever I must to meet her. But by this point, the basket had floated away, the music with it, and the girls all inside. Red Hawk decided he would sleep out again And again he slept out beneath those stars and the moon, hoping that the next day the basket would return from the sky with the celestial sisters in it. And sure enough, he was not disappointed, for that next morning with the rising of the sun, the basket came from the sky with its music. Red Hawk, you know, could change his shape, as native people often could during this time. And Red Hawk changed his shape into an opossum. And that opossum scurried out. As the sisters got out of the basket and began to dance, the opossum got closer and closer and closer through the tall grass. The sisters spotted the opossum, and so startled they were that they climbed quickly into the basket and floated away. Red Hawk shrugged off his animal skin and sat in the grass. I must think of another way, he thought. And just as he was thinking that, by his feet scurried a family of field mice. Aha, said Red Hawk. If I become one of them, then the sisters will not be suspicious of me. They will not be afraid, for I do mean them no harm. For a third night he slept out underneath those stars. And on the third morning, when the sun rose, Red Hawk changed his shape into one of those mice and joined the whole family. What he suspected was correct, for the music came and the basket floated in and the celestial sisters climbed out, grabbed hands and began to dance in a circle, the field mice scurrying around their feet. Well, Red Hawk scurried himself right over to the feet of the youngest sister. And as the other sisters got into the basket, he shrugged off his shape and took her hands. Stay with me, he said. Well, the youngest sister was so startled to see not a field mouse, but a young man, that she paused for a minute, looked in his eyes, and was overcome with warmth. For while she loved her home in the sky, something drew her to this brave young man, Red Hawk, who stood before her. The sisters floated up and away, and happily she took his hand. Come with me, he said, I will show you where I live. And together they went through the woods. The celestial sister looked all around at the wonderful woods, the mushrooms, and the mosses that grew at the base of the tree, touching them to see how fuzzy and funny they felt beneath her fingers. Back to Red Hawk's lodge they went, and happily they were married by the chief of the village. The celestial sister missed her home in the sky, but happy she was with Red Hawk, and over time a son was born to them. Well, as the son began to grow, he began to learn to fish, just as Red Hawk learned to fish. And he began to learn to hunt, just as Red Hawk learned to hunt. But his mother, she loved her life on the earth, but began to miss her life in the stars, and thought, I wish to go home. I wish to take my little son with me and go home. She knew that Red Hawk would never want to leave the earth. This was his home, but it really wasn't truly hers. So in secret, she began to weave a basket, like the one that had brought her to the earth. Day after day she wove that basket, until when it was ready, she put it in the exact spot in the meadow, got her young son, and climbed inside with him. Red Hawk was off hunting when this happened, but in the distance, all of a sudden he heard the strange music. Fear gripped his heart, for he knew what had happened, and he began to run as quickly as he could between the trees, all the way through the forest. He got to the meadow and fell on his knees in despair as the basket with his wife and son lifted up into the sky. Red Hawk returned to his home with his head in his hands. His wife, the Celestial Sister, meantime, had arrived back home in the stars. She was greeted by all of her sisters and her father and all of the other warriors of the sky who were so happy to meet her son and to see her once again. They lived that way for a long time. Each day Red Hawk would return to the meadow, hoping to hear the music, to see his wife and son return. But alas, it did not happen. In the sky, Red Hawk's young son grew, and as he became a young man, he began to ask about his father. The Celestial Sister told him, "Your father is a man of the earth. I wish to meet him," he said. "I wish to know who he is. He is a brave hunter. I wish to be a brave hunter." But the Celestial Sister said no, for she was afraid that if her son returned to earth, he would never return again. Torn she was between the two worlds. One day her father, the wisest of the celestial people, came to her. A boy should know his father. "Oh no," she said, "I cannot return." "You must," he said, "for it is now time. Invite your brave warrior to come to the sky. Tell him that we have heard of what a wonderful hunter he is, and we would like to meet him." "She will never leave," he said. "She loves the earth. He loves the earth. He will never leave. He will never come back." "No, no, you must ask him," said the wise one. "Tell him to bring something from each animal that has been a part of his hunt. It could be a claw or a feather, but something different. Bring a whole collection of items for us to see here in the sky, for him to show what a great hunter he is." And so with reluctance, the Celestial Sister got in the basket with her son, who could not wait, and floated to the earth. It was the morning, and Red Hawk had done his daily walk, and he heard the music. Joy filled his heart, and he ran swift-footed through the woods, got to the field just as the basket landed. He embraced his wife and looked. "What a fine young man my son has become," he said. "Come, come with me." And so they returned back to the lodge, happiness flowing through all three of them. That evening by the fire, the Celestial Sister told her husband of the offer of the wise one. "I will go," said Red Hawk. "I have no doubt in my heart. It is time for me to see your land as you have seen mine." And he began the next day to gather things: a claw from an eagle, a feather, many feathers of all different types of birds, the pelt of an animal, always done with care. Red Hawk gathered those items and collected them in the basket. And when he had enough, he felt in his heart, he said, "Tomorrow we will go." The next morning, as the sun rose, the three got into the basket. And that music began to play as the basket lifted high into the sky. Red Hawk looked all across the land. He had never seen it like this. He could see far and wide, all the way to where the river flowed, and where the trees grew taller than he could even see the tops of them. He was amazed. "I am like a bird," he said, for in his heart, he had always loved the hawks and felt their freedom to fly wherever they wished. "Now I can fly too," thought Red Hawk. And laughing, he enjoyed the view from far and wide. When they arrived up into the Sky Kingdom, Red Hawk was greeted by all of the celestial people. The wise one came forward and welcomed him with a small bow. But Red Hawk felt that that was not necessary. He was the one who should bow as the gracious guest, and so he did. He was welcomed by all and took out all of the treasures to show the wise one all that he had brought. The people gathered round. They had never seen such things, for except for the sisters, they had never voyaged to the earth. "Now," said the wise one, "I have an offer for each one of you. But think wisely before you make it, for once your choice is made, your choice cannot be undone." All of the people gathered with quiet and listened as the wise one spoke. "You may remain here," he said, "in the sky with me as one of the celestial beings. Or you may choose one of the gifts that Red Hawk has brought us. However, if you choose a gift, you will become the animal that the gift came from, and you will forever live as that animal." Well, one after the other, the people came up. One took the pelt of a deer and instantly was transformed into a deer and found themselves on the earth, running in the meadows and through the trees. Another chose a small bird, another a beaver. All chose until it was just Red Hawk, his wife, and his son. Red Hawk looked at the two, and the three each chose the feather of a hawk, and the three were changed into hawks, where together they could roam not only the sky, but also the earth, and be together for the end of their days.